Welcome back, aspiring chemists. In this video, I'll be showing you how to make sulfuric acid at home. Sulfuric acid is a very useful acid with many applications, from fertilizers to car batteries to detergents. More reason why every amateur chemist should have it in their arsenal. Now, you can either buy sulfuric acid, as it's a relatively cheap chemical, or you can make it at home. Now, there are a lot of methods used to make sulfuric acid. But in this video, I'll be showing you how to make sulfuric acid using Epsom salt. And in my opinion, this is the simplest method for making sulfuric acid. If you want to see me try other methods of making sulfuric acid in the future, subscribe now so you don't miss my upcoming videos. For this experiment, the materials you will need are Epsom salt, some plastic containers, and a DC power supply. This is basically the same setup I used when I made hydrochloric acid and sodium hydroxide. Feel free to check it out. To start off, we dissolve our magnesium sulfate in water in one container. This will be our solution B. And then we add ordinary distilled water to our other container. That would be our solution A. We will also need a piece of cloth or anything absorbent, as this will serve as our salt bridge. Next, we plug in our DC power supply, put our salt bridge in each solution, and then we insert our terminals. Now let's take a closer look at this setup. The copper terminal serves as our cathode, as it is negatively charged, and the graphite terminal serves as our anode, as it is positively charged. The whole aim of this setup is to separate the ions of the salt away from each other so that they recombine in the different solution, forming our hydroxide and our favorite sulfuric acid. After a while, the current picks up and we start seeing bubbles. These gases are a byproduct of the electrolytic process. The gas formed at the copper terminal is hydrogen, and the one formed at the graphite terminal is oxygen. If you want me to go in depth into how this process really works, drop the word electrolysis in the comment section, and once I see enough of it, I will drop a full breakdown in my community tab. Also, we check the pH of each of the solutions at the start of the experiment. Checking the pH for solution B, we see that it is nearly neutral. And checking the pH for solution A, we also see that it is nearly neutral. Now we leave the electrolysis to run for about an hour and we'll come back to check on it. While this method is extremely easy, it has its limitations. First off, you have to continuously maintain the setup, as the copper electrode will be passivated by magnesium hydroxide, so it has to be removed continuously for the reaction to go on. Also, oxygen will be given off as the graphite terminal, and this will cause it to decompose into a gas, depleting your electrode. So you either use lead dioxide electrode, which isn't entirely safe, or you use platinum metal. I don't have any of that at the moment, so I'm stuck with graphite. The second is that the acid you get at the end of this process will be very dilute, and you may need to concentrate it. Either way, we let the setup to run for a few days to achieve maximum concentration. It has been 2 weeks of continuous electrolysis, and now for the moment of truth, we check the pH of each solution. For solution B, the paper shows green, indicating a pH of around 8 to 9 due to the insoluble hydroxide formed, and for solution A, the paper shows a deep red due to the strong acid formed. Now we disassemble the setup and filter our solution A. The reason why the magnesium sulfate was dissolved in only one vessel was so that the resulting sulfuric acid solution that we will get will be free of any magnesium ions. Once the filtration is complete, we boil our solution to concentrate the acid. I have about 300 mL here, so I will boil it down to about 100 mL. As we boil, we try to ensure that the temperature stays below 100 degrees. Once the temperature rises above 100, you are boiling the acid and the fumes are very toxic. If you don't have a thermometer, watch out for the fumes. Once you start seeing thick white fumes, you are boiling the acid and you would have to stop, unless you want a very concentrated sulfuric acid solution. Now that I have boiled away most of the water, we have our fairly concentrated acid. To test that, we use a famous bicarbonate test. We simply add our sodium bicarbonate into a plastic and then introduce the acid. This will lead to fizzing, telling us that we have a good amount of acid in solution. Our solution B is still rich in magnesium sulfate, so we store it for further electrolysis. To get more acid, you can simply repeat the process that we have discussed. This is the insoluble magnesium hydroxide. It should be white though. Anyways, I have no use for it, so I'm discarding it. And there you have it. We have successfully synthesized sulfuric acid with simple materials. If you found this method valuable, hit that like button, subscribe to the Aspiring Chemist, and join the experiment.